heard a story once about a woman who was driving down the highway and she came across this horrible accident. She decided to get out of her car to see if she could help. When she did, she found this man who had been violently thrown from his car. He was in pretty bad shape. So later on when she talked about it, she said that, "I was really grateful that all my first aid experience came back to me at that moment when I really needed it. I immediately put my head between my knees to keep myself from getting sick." That woman was obviously not going to be helping anybody that day. She was way too absorbed in herself. And not so long ago, I was exactly like her. I was in control of my world, and I knew it all. For example, I knew that I was the only thing that my husband needed. All his joy and all his fulfillment came purely from me. Except for on Sunday mornings and Wednesday nights when I'd find myself home alone. And then a random Saturday here, or a whole weekend there, something was going on and I didn't like it. Brian had started volunteering with youth group, and that was fine with me, but why did he have to be gone so long? I mean, I was supposed to be all he needed, right? So I did the only rational thing I could think of. I fought with him. I would rage and scream and cry, and he would wait till I was done and rationally explain his side of the story. It sort of reflected my relationship with God. I would persuade and beg and demand from God, and the whole time God was just waiting for me to listen to what he had to say, but I never did. A month or so before the fall retreat, Brian came to prepare me. A fall retreat to me meant a whole weekend without my husband. And I was preparing all the arguments already ready for him. I went with the classic, "If you really love me, you'd stay home with me." But before I ever got it out, he said, "Why don't you come along?" "What? No, no, I can't come along. I would just get in the way. I wouldn't be any help. Good grief, as childish as I am, I'd probably be the one to start the food fight." But then I started thinking, you know, maybe he had a more devious plan. Maybe he thought that if we went to the retreat and I got jealous and upset, that I wouldn't be able to throw my normal tantrum. Oh, he's a sneaky man. I thought it was Brian, but, and far more likely, it was God stepping in and using Brian to finally get through to me. So I started volunteering with the youth group. It kind of felt like going to high school all over again. I mean, there were times that were really great and I was happy and things were wonderful. But then there were also times that I was really scared and didn't know what to do, and sometimes I'd drive home in tears. There were times I thought about quitting, but Brian always said, "Wait till the fall retreat, give it that long, and then if you don't like it, then you can quit." Well, obviously he didn't understand. So, as you do when nobody understands you, I finally turned to God. But I was completely certain that he wasn't gonna understand me either. Oh, how wrong I was. God did understand, and he'd already had a plan for that weekend. I just needed to be there to hear it. You know, I'm really amazed with what God can do with a selfish, pig-headed heart like mine. He's got this way of opening your heart up to others when you just shut your mouth and follow him. I started really getting to know the girls in my small group. I mean, it's kind of hard not to when you bunk with each other for a weekend. I mean, after all, we did share a bathroom. We'd eat together and talk together and play games together. I think the only thing we didn't do together that weekend was sleep. I don't think any of us slept. But one thing we did do was sit together during the sermons. And I remember one sermon in particular, it really hit me. All right, I really like these kids and, you know, I want to help them out, but good grief, what if I, you know, really mess them up? I mean, obviously I don't have my life all in order. And what if I give them the wrong advice or steer them in the wrong direction? I can't do this. I don't belong here. Just about that time in the sermon, the speaker told some advice that a friend gave him when he was having a really tough time in his life. He said, "We don't have to know it all. We just have to trust the one who does." All right, God, finally, I get it. I'll shut up and follow. It's really amazing when you finally get what God's trying to tell you. I mean, I'm not saying that there aren't going to be days where I still think I know it all, but I really do know the one who does. And he's been keeping me kind of busy, you know, with youth group. There's lesson writing and sleepover planning and shopping trips and service projects and theme nights. I just better make sure that Brian doesn't get too lonely.